The Jack Benny Program, presented by Lucky Strike. Lucky Strike, burst again with Tobacco Men. Burst again with Tobacco Men. Lucky Strike. More independent tobacco experts smoke Lucky Strike regularly than the next two leading brands combined.
There you have the findings of a recent impartial survey, which reveals the personal smoking preference of the men who really know tobacco. The auctioneers, buyers, and warehousemen.
Yes, the survey shows...
Lucky Strike, first again with Tobacco Men.
First again with Tobacco Men. First again with the men who can see the makers of Lucky Strike consistently select and buy that fine, that light, that naturally mild tobacco. And when these experts smoke Lucky Strike for their own personal smoking enjoyment, then you know...
LSMFT, LSMFT.
Lucky Strike means fine tobacco. And in a cigarette, it's the tobacco that counts. So for your own real, deep-down smoking enjoyment, smoke the smoke tobacco experts smoke. Lucky Strike,
first again with Tobacco Men.
The Lucky Strike program starring Jack Benny with Mary Livingston, Phil Harris, Rochester, Dennis Day, and yours truly, Don Wilson. And now, ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to present to you a man whose charm and personality have gained him millions of admirers. A man who's not only loved for his... Wait a minute, I must have the wrong script. This is introducing Robert Taylor.
That's right, Don. Jack has gone away on a week's vacation, and Robert Taylor is taking his place. He should be here any minute.
Robert Taylor? Oh, that's wonderful. But, Mary, I still can't get over Jack's just packing up and going away on a trip.
Well, it's more than just a trip, Don. Jack is spending a glorious week in New York.
What made him decide to go so suddenly?
He won it on the bride and groom program.
Bride and groom program. You mean that our own little Jackie boy ran off and got married?
Well, not exactly, Don. But Jack figured here was a way to get a trip for nothing, so he got someone to go through the ceremony with him.
But what girl would go along with a gag like that? Mary, what are you laughing at?
He couldn't get a girl, so he hired a man with a tuxedo, and Jack wore his Charlie's Aunt costume. With a veil yet.
Well, Mary, if it was all a gag, why didn't he come to you with the idea?
He did. That's why he wore the veil. I punched him in the nose. Anyway, Don, till Bob gets here, I think that we...
Hiya, Dante. Hello, Livy, you little May Company magnolia.
Hello, Phil.
Hey, Livy, where's Jackson?
Jack won't be on the program today.
Oh, he won't? What's wrong?
Nothing's wrong. He just decided to take a vacation. He needed a rest.
Well, it's his own fault.
What?
If Jackson had hired a truck instead of carrying his money to the bank, he wouldn't be so worn out.
Now, Phil, Jack doesn't have that much money.
He don't, huh? When Jackson goes to the bank to make a deposit, he's carrying so many bags, the teller puts on a red cap and meets him at the door.
Phil.
And then the vice president grabs a microphone and yells, "Leave it on track five, another load for Fort Knox."
Okay, Phil. You don't have to start being such a big comedian just because Jack is off this week. He got Robert Taylor to fill in for him.
He got who?
Robert Taylor.
Oh, you mean Spangler Arlington Brew? Spangler Arlington Brew.
Well...
Wait a minute. Let's just mull over that. Don't get in a hurry, Liv. We can cut that up into some pretty parts, you know.
Well, Phil... That's his real name, but on the screen, he's known as Robert Taylor.
How do you like that?
What's the matter, Phil?
Well, why does Jackson want to get somebody else when he's got me? Why, baby, I'm radio's answer to the governor of Alabama. Me, little filthy. Yes, that pretty thing. The kid with a soothing personality.
Phil, your personality is about as soothing as an eyewash with Tabasco sauce. So whether you like it or not, Robert Taylor's going to be on the show.
Okay, but if you don't show up pretty soon, I'm taking over.
Oh, no, you're not.
Mary, maybe we ought to check and see if Bob has started for the studio yet, huh?
Oh, that's a good idea, Don. I think I will.
Oh, great shoes. What is it, Mabel?